Hey, I'm Greg.
And I'm Jimmy.
And Honda Racing F1 have asked us to show you exactly how their master engineers achieve energy saving as big as this.
Yes, so this balloon doesn't look much like a Formula One racing car, but they do share one thing in common. They both reuse energy that would otherwise be lost as hot air.
Now, you lose a lot of heat energy out the back of your exhaust pipe on a car, but just like the hot air produced by this burner, the molecules in those hot exhaust gases are excited.
Just like this.
Yeah. Now, temperature is just a number that we use to represent the amount of kinetic energy that the particles or molecules in a gas have. If you increase the temperature, you increase the amount of energy you give them. They jiggle around more, they bounce off each other more, and they bounce off whatever surface they're hitting, which for us is the inside of the balloon. Increase the temperature, you increase the pressure.
Which in the case of our balloon here means that as we heat up the molecules inside, they expand, filling our balloon.
Come on then, let's take it up. Slowly, slowly, slowly. Ready, ready? Yes!
We've got lift off.
Lift off! I got it. It's got some oomph. So it's about 45, 50 degrees C in there, which is, of course, really warm. But in an F1 power unit, the hot exhaust gases reach 20 times that, almost 1,000 degrees C. That would normally be a lot of wasted heat energy. But the F1 engineers have come up with a brilliant way of capturing it and reusing it.
In our balloon, the hot air is trapped, forcing it up. But in an F1 power unit, that hot air is forced out and down through the exhaust.
When you ignite the fuel in the ICE, the hot expanding exhaust gases rush out through the exhaust pipe. They've got a lot of kinetic energy, they've got a lot of force. When we put a turbine in their way, in the exhaust pipe, we can capture and harness that power.
We've already seen how a turbine powers a turbocharger, but with so much excess heat in that exhaust driving that turbine, we can use that excess power to drive something else. But to do that, we're gonna need something bigger than this.
Wicked, bigger means more fire, right?
Oh yeah.
Bigger flames. Mate, what do I do with this?
So this is our version of a turbine, which is normally found inside the exhaust pipe of a Formula One car. I've supersized it so we can see the action better. And at the bottom there, there is a special type of motor called an MGU-H.
The MGU-H converts heat energy into electrical energy. And you can see, hit it, mate. You can see how it's done. The heat energy pushes up against the turbine. It turns the turbine. That turns the motor, the MGU-H, and that produces electrical energy. You can see the lights down the bottom.
And that energy can be put back into the car when it's needed.
But that burner has nowhere near the same amount of power as you get in a Formula One power unit. Inside a Formula One ICE, you've got 750 explosions every second. And all of that heat from all of those explosions is directed towards the turbine to make it spin.
To achieve something like that, we're gonna have to change our heat source to something that represents 750 explosions every second.
Yeah, we're gonna have to supersize. Yeah, so that's 750 rockets strapped to a turbine, all with a 1 second fuse, and I've got the ignition system.
A rocket powered turbine. That's not normal.
No, it's just, yeah. Nice knowing you, mate.
Yeah.
Nice knowing you.
So hopefully we're gonna get a massive burst of power from our MGU-H into our junction box. And this time I'm gonna send that energy to our energy source so we can capture all that electricity we generate.
I don't think this has ever been done this big before.
I doubt it.
I have no idea how far we need to go back, but let's start walking.
I'm going that way.
Right then. Genuinely a little bit nervous. Ready?
Yeah, here we go.
Arm. Fire. Yeah. Still smoking! Oh, that
was incredible.
That was absolutely amazing. And just look at how much electrical energy we've managed to store. Now, the absolutely crazy thing is that during an F1 race, 750 explosions are happening every second, constantly, which means that the MGU-H can constantly be converting that heat energy into electrical energy. And unlike the MGU-K, the amount of electrical energy that the MGU-H is allowed to convert is unlimited. Now, that gives a real opportunity for F1 teams to gain a huge advantage to maximize when and how they actually use that energy.
And just like in our turbine, the energy from the MGU-H in the car can also be sent to the energy store here and can be saved for later use. But not only that, it is cleverer because that energy can also be sent to the turbocharger, and that's pretty impressive because what that does is stop turbo lag when the turbo could slow down by speeding it up, keeping the ICE working at maximum power.
Also, it can be sent via the MGU-K directly to power the wheels. That's why the MGU-H is such an important piece of tech in the battle for efficient F1 racing.
Check out our next episode when, just like our junction box, we'll be looking at a supercomputer that can do over 1 million measurements a second. That's the car's onboard computer.
Right, we've got a little bit of cleaning up to do. Only 749 to go. Subscribe to the Honda Racing F1 YouTube channel to make sure you can see the next film as soon as it goes live. Right, let's clean up. It's gonna take a while.
I'll get the mop.